719 in numerology means that you should listen to your spiritual guide and embrace new beginnings, the new RouterOS version. I did not come up with this. It's all written in the occult books. The version is out, and there are a lot of small fixes and improvements. The word fix has been mentioned more than 80 times in the changelog, so it is definitely a new beginning. If you want to read through the changes yourself, check out the full list on MikroTik.com download section or have a look at the forum announcements. Now let's go over the things that caught the eye of your guide. When adding a new bonding interface using the link aggregation control protocol, you now have a new parameter called LACP mode, where you can specify whether it should be passive or active. Until now, both sides were set as active by default, and for most people that wasn't an issue. The bridge port monitor can now report on more STP-RSTP data, such as the number of BPDU transmissions and time since the last topology change. A more exciting improvement is the addition to a built-in root certificate authorities store. Now your router can finally check in with certificate authorities out of the box to verify HTTPS addresses. Previously, your device could only check the certificates needed for software upgrades. If you wanted to integrate with some online resources, you would have to manually import the related root certificate. While not a direct change in this version, related to certificates, RouterOS can now handle the Let's Encrypt DNS challenge without requiring an open port 80 as with the HTTP challenge. This DNS challenge can also be used in the background for some of our cloud functionality. Moving on, the RouterOS console has a couple of useful additions. You can now add an on-error clause to 4 and 4 each loops. We already had error catching mechanisms, but this addition allows for the easy creation of loops that do not get interrupted by errors. Here's a little example of a loop that will error out every other loop, but it has this new clause that will prevent it from stopping. If I run this, you can see that the loop completes successfully even though every other one produced an error. Another console improvement is that the monitor command can now take proplist. This means that if we want to keep track of one interface, we don't have to look at everything. We could just look at RX packets and RX bits, for example. This is not limited to interfaces. Essentially, anywhere where you can execute the monitor command, you can now select specific data points you want to keep an eye on. Next up, container names can now be changed, but better yet, when you're adding a container from a remote resource, it will automatically be given a human-readable name. As you can see, Alpine latest makes much more sense than this long gibberish that I have for this previously created container. Then there have been some DHCP touch-ups. When configuring a DHCP server, you now have a new attribute called use reconfigure. If you set it to yes, the server will force its clients to renew their leases whenever there are any configuration changes to the server. For example, if you change the DNS or NTP server address, that change will be immediately pushed out to all clients. This is not part of the standard DHCP operation, so for the clients to accept these reconfigure messages, you have to also change the client settings. If you go to the Advanced tab, there is an Allow Reconfigure Messages. Besides this, there is another new option called Check Gateway. You might recognize that from the Route section, where it is one of the parameters when configuring a route. If enabled, there is an automatic gateway check running in the background, occurring once every 10 seconds. When the gateway is not detected, the route can be ignored, ensuring a simple way to do failover. When a DHCP client adds a default route, it can now also add this gateway check automatically. File handling continues to be improved. Besides better responsiveness, it is now possible to list invisible files within RouterOS. When issuing file print, you can now add the show hidden parameter and it will reveal all the files and folders that start with a dot. The IP services section has had a revamp. It now displays not only the RouterOS services that can be disabled or remapped to a different port, but also lets you monitor everything going on in your system. All the services that are running and all the connections that are established to the respective ports will be displayed here. For example, you can see I have an active Winbox connection. If I start up a container with an SSH server and try to connect to it, both the newly opened container port and the SSH connection will show up in this list, displaying both directions separately. And the last noteworthy mentions, WireGuard import can now accept your configuration not only as a file, but you can also simply paste it in as a string. And then BTRFS now has the balance command and degraded arrays can now be mounted too. That's it for 719. Stay tuned for 720, which in some circles is referred to as high definition.